Welcome, everybody. My name is Andreas Meyer, and I'm the host of the Pattern Recognition Symposium. This semester, we are completely online, which is the reason why I can show a couple of the presentations to you in this online format. So the next presentation will be given by Christian Marzahl, and it's entitled Real Deep Learning Can Generalize to More Than One Species, a Comparative Three Species Whole Slide Image Dataset. Very much looking forward to your presentation.
Let's start. Let's take a look at it. Well, over the course of the last year, we collected 57 and queen samples, and queen mean horses, by the way. And our first contribution for scientific reports was we trained a model on 17 of this 57 slides. So we have a pre-trained model available for this data set. Additionally, we collected 14 cat samples and 18 human samples. And as you can already see, well, they look quite different. So that raises some questions. First of all, how to efficiently create a fully annotated, high-quality multi-species dataset out of these three species? So our approach is quite simple. Well, we want to try an interspecies domain transfer, meaning we have our trained model for horses and want to see, okay, does it also work for cats and for humans without any adaptions or with minimal adaptions? And second, to create a high profile data set, human experts have to check it. So we have EXACT, our online annotation tool with specialization for expert algorithm collaboration, and we have some pretty nice visualization techniques. And combining that, we want now to create this big, really big data set. Just for comparison, the biggest data set in this field consists of 17 whole slide images. We are going up to around 100 of them. So let's go a little bit deeper in our preconditions. So we have this RetinaNet trained on 17 of these whole slide images. In the bottom, you see the classes, class 1, class 0 to 4. Depending on the hemosiderin concentration. So our disease is caused by bleeding into the lung, or we have bleeding into the lungs. Then we take a sample from it, we digitalize it, and we say, okay, how severe is this bleeding? So that was our first publication. In our next publication for the Mika, we looked into it. Okay, if we have multiple users, multiple experts, how is the intra and inter-rater observability, meaning if you have one data set and give it to two or up to 10 experts, what are the results? What is the range of results you get? And additionally, we showed them some pre-computed annotations and said, okay, please correct them. Please use them for your annotations. And we noticed some quite heavy boost and speed up for the annotation process. But also we figured out, okay, there's a big bias towards accepting pre-computed annotations. Then we combined this two publications for our EXACT server. EXACT is our online annotation tool. And we said, okay, with a good clustering and customization techniques, we can combat this bias toward accepting pre-computed annotation. Also, we needed annotation versioning. You will see later why that's important. And we want to say, okay, we want some cooperative annotation work. So now we have the groundwork, let's dive into it. So first, inference. So we used our model trained on 17 in-queen samples. And with that, we performed inference. And we created almost 1 million null sites. So you can imagine, well, that's a big data set and you have to check it because we want a high quality data set. So we really have to check it by a human. So well, that raises the already mentioned question. So you can see here, okay, it looks quite good. And now we come to Exact's first nice feature. If I click on it, well, sorry, it was going on the other screen. Exact is bringing me exactly to that positions, and we see here how these annotations are loaded. We can see here, okay, even if the cells are very clustered, the algorithm was perfectly able to separate them, and we get some really nice looking results. And yeah, we can see here, okay, it's 13,000 annotations for this whole slide. So loading all of them takes some seconds. Okay, now we have inference. Now we have our new annotations. Let's go to the next step. We created some semi-automatic data cleaning pipeline because we noticed, especially on the cat slides, okay, the cells are not very well defined. So we had some issues with, you can see it here, half cell. So the cell border is not really good. Additionally, on cat slides, we noticed a new type of cells, granulocytes. This type of cell was not present in our training set. So we had a lot of false positives. And again, we clustered it by width, and we see here, okay, our half cells are in the left corner and the granulocytes are starting from here. And so we said, okay, it's easy to separate them. Okay, so we have the next step. We have a semi-automatic cleaning pipeline. Okay, let's go to screening. For screening, we said, okay, the expert has to look at each slide, but we want some comfort features, like we want to memorize where the user ended or where the pathology stopped last time. So with one click, he can go back to that slide 1 week or another or later and start re-annotating. You see that here in green, everything is marked where our pathologist actually annotated, and yeah, we can go through the slides. So coming to the last step of our pipeline, we want to correct classification errors. So we trained a regression network. You see here in blue grade 0 to yellow grade 4 cells, so the highest class. And now we start to visualize them. And you see it here, okay, we have class 2, class 3. And if here would be a dark blue cell, we would easily be able to spot that and correct it. So with this type of visualization, we also try to improve our dataset quality. That actually brings me to our results. So we are halfway in this process. You can see we have a lot of blank lines. So it takes some time to annotate and to correct this big data set. But we already see we have around 70% in user interaction reduction. So we can quite good create this big data set. We started with 330,000 cells, and we are now down to 242,000. And you will think, well, that's almost 20%. That's a lot. Why you have so much false positives who our expert removed? Well, we looked into it, started to look into it, and our pathologist was so kind to annotate exactly the same slides he annotated 1 year ago again. And you can see in blue, 1 year ago, and in orange, within the last weeks. And he corrected, or he deleted up to 40% of the cells he annotated 1 year before. So that's a huge difference. So we can say, okay, it's not a problem of the network because that's too much false positive. No, even experts vary very lot, very much in their grading task. But we have first conclusions we would draw. The combination of Exact with these pre-trained models and human experts can lead to the creation of high quality big data sets. And we have some big to-dos. And I would kindly ask you if you have more to-dos, more interesting things, we are in the middle of the process for creating this data set, please write me some. So we want to definitely do an interspecies cross-validation in two modes. First, trained with the ground truth from our human annotator or human expert, and additionally by the algorithmically created ground truth, so the noisy student model. Additionally, we want definitely to look deeper into what causes grading and counting difference. So why we have 20% less cells than last year for the same data set. Is it a selection bias now towards good-looking high-grade cells? Is it caused by classification errors? Or is the definition of cells, or this type of cells, these macrophages we are looking for, not very good defined? So is this maybe ambitious? What is really a macrophage? And you can say, today it's one, and if you look tomorrow again, and you say, maybe not, it's not a macrophage. So we have this now this big data set or an equation of it, and we have some pretty good ideas what we want to do with it for this publication. But that actually brings me to the end of my presentation. I thank you for your attention, and if you want to give exact a shot, here you have the link and a barcode. Thank you very much.